folks. What did you do this past week? Me, I decorated a Christmas tree. And I do mean this past week. How long does it take a normal person to decorate a Christmas tree? I don't know, maybe 2 hours, you think? Does that sound reasonable? And if Novoblatz had his way, we'd have a little 2-foot tree on a table somewhere. It's not a big deal for him. But me, well, I'm a little persnickety about my Christmas tree. I'm a little bit of a fuss budget when it comes to decorating it. And it took me the week, pretty much. So here's the deal. I went out last Saturday, so this is Sunday that I'm filming this, so a week ago, Saturday. I went out and picked out a tree and brought it home. And Novoblatz got, he has basically two parts of the process. When I first bring home a tree, he cuts off the bottom of it and removes the lower branches and helps me get it in the stand. And then he's done until it's time to take the tree down. And then once I have it completely undecorated, he helps me get it out of the stand and hauls it out to the street. So he has it pretty easy. And I can't fuss too much because, like I said, I'm a little persnickety about my Christmas tree. And it's probably just easier for me to do the decorating myself, because otherwise I'd be going around behind him and rearranging things. So Saturday I got the tree. We got it in the stand. That was all by roughly lunchtime on Saturday. And you have to let the branches relax in order to do any decorations. And so I had to wait a bit. I had to wait till Saturday night to finally get the lights on the tree. And I have to tell you, that's the one part I absolutely hate doing. I hate putting the lights on the tree. I love the look of the lights on the tree, but I hate putting them on there. I have 9 strands of lights on this tree. And so it's a lot of up and down step stools going around and around the tree, in and out of the branches, because you want light inside and outside. And in my opinion, I don't have enough lights on my tree, because this year's tree is a little bit taller and healthy girth to it. So I wish I had a few more lights, but oh well, I digress. So anyway, that was Saturday. Sunday, I had a whole bunch of things I had to do. So I only had about probably 3 hours to devote to working on the tree. And I managed to get about half the ornaments on in 3 hours. Novoblatz says I have too many. I say I don't have enough. Anyway, come Monday, you know, I'm back at work, so I don't have a whole lot of time. And all I had was roughly, I don't know, 30 to 60 minutes at night between getting done with work and making dinner to get some more ornaments on the tree. So it took me Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday night, I finally finished putting the ornaments on the tree. And like I said, it doesn't have enough. It really, really needed more ornaments. I have bare spots. I hate to admit it. They're against the wall so nobody can see them, but I know they're there. I'm gonna have to make some more ornaments. That's all there is to it. And I don't mean make, because that's for the most part, I'd say that at least half, if not maybe even 2/3 of the ornaments on my tree are homemade in some fashion. In some cases, it's just jewelry converted to ornaments. And in some cases, it's truly made from scratch type ornaments. If you watched, I did a video last year talking about the kind of things that I have on my tree. And if you saw that, then you know I don't do a designer tree. I don't go out and buy all color coordinated ornaments and make it up like it belongs in a magazine. Instead, my ornaments are all, for the most part, they have a story behind them. In some cases, I've forgotten the story because, after all, it's been a long time. The oldest ornaments on there, sadly, I don't have any of the ones from my childhood. But they date back from when my daughter was a baby. And my daughter has 3 babies of her own, so you can imagine that's a long time. There are a lot of ornaments that came from that period. I was a single mom to Jen for a while, in between my first marriage and being married to Paul Novoblatz. And during those years when I was a single mom, money was tight, so I couldn't spend money on decorations. So we have a bunch of, for instance, seashells that got turned into ornaments that we had picked up on our local beaches. And because she was so young, I didn't dare have glass ornaments anyway. I have a bunch of felt ornaments that were safe for her to be around. And then later on, there were some that she and I made together, some pipe cleaner ornaments and things like that. And then there are the ones that she made when she was in school. So there's a lot of homemade ornaments on my tree. And then there are various and sundry store-bought ones, but even some of the store-bought ones have some kind of meaning behind them. So that's part of what takes a while when I decorate my tree, is I'm pulling each piece out. I remember where I can the stories behind the ornaments. For instance, I have this gorgeous, very large crystal snowflake that I had a favorite aunt, Aunt Thelma, and she loved Christmas. Every room in her house was all decked out every year for Christmas. And so one year I'd bought her one of this large crystal snowflake to go on her tree, and I loved it so much I bought myself one just like it. And to this day, whenever I hang it on my tree, I think of Aunt Thelma. She passed away many years ago, but so that's special. It always gets a very special place on the tree. And after 9/11, and those of you here in the U.S., that's why you need to say it's 9/11. After that, I bought a American flag, a pewter American flag ornament, and that always gets a special place on the tree. There is a little store-bought polar bear ornament, inexpensive little thing, but I love polar bears, so it always gets a special spot on the tree. Things like that. So there are store-bought ones that still have special meaning behind them, as well as all the homemade ones. So it's part of why it takes a while is that, you know, stopping and thinking about the memories that are attached. But then there's where to put it on my tree. Including, I mean, I'll be honest, even though I finished decorating the tree on Thursday, right up through Christmas, I'll probably still go over there every once in a while and rearrange things, because I'll look at it from a different point of view, a different angle of viewing, and go, wait a minute, there are two things too close together there, or there's a bare spot there, and I'll go pick something up over here and move it over there, so I can't have, you know, like I don't have a bunch of red things all close together. I keep the colors hopefully fairly broken up and mixed. It's a never-ending process, you know. I'm the same way, unfortunately, at work. I'll tweak things. I do graphic design and typesetting and things like that for my job, and I will go in and tweak things all the time. It's like it's never good enough. It's never perfect, so I'm always adjusting things. And the same thing with my tree. I'm always adjusting things. So as I was decorating the tree this year, I had the thought, just how many ornaments are on my tree? I'm almost afraid to find out. I've never actually counted, you know. It's not like I've got three boxes of Christmas balls or something like that. No, I mean, especially because some of these things are really tiny, because they're like little earrings got converted into a little dangly ornament so that something sparkly on the tree. So I'm really afraid to see how many there are, but I've decided when I take down the tree this year, I'm going to count how many ornaments are on the tree. I'm really, really, really afraid to see what that number is going to be. But when I'm done with shooting this video, I'm going to go out to the living room and shoot a little bit of the tree so you can take a look at it. Maybe you want to make a guess. How many ornaments do you think are on the tree? And there's a lot. I mean, like I said, there's a lot of these little things. Because I can't put tinsel on the tree, or you might call them icicles, it's these things that you would use on a live tree. Is they came in a box. We used it when I was a kid growing up. They're silvery, thin, like a pliable plastic, kind of like a film kind of a thing, if you know what I'm talking about. And you would drip it on the branches so it looked like icicles hanging off your tree. Well, I have cats, and cats will eat that stuff and get extremely ill and possibly die. So I can't have tinsel on my tree like that. So instead, I have goo gobs of plastic, hard plastic icicles that hang by hooks and things that I've bought different times over the year, so they don't match. There's different kinds. There's including some red plastic things that I think were probably on somebody's chandelier. Like I said, back when I was a single mom and money was tight, so one of the things I did was I went to yard sales, garage sales, things like that, and looked for. A lot of times people just have a whole bag of old junk jewelry or whatnots and things. And I found these at one of these yard sales that someone had taken off of a chandelier, and they were just selling the little danglies. They're about 6 inches long. They're pretty long. And they were red, so perfect for a Christmas tree. So they're on there. I've got some gold ones, but most of them are clear. But again, like I said, because I've bought them at different times over the years, they're different shapes and sizes, but they're all over the tree for my icicle effect. And I've got these little, like, berries. These came from, you can buy floral sprays and things like that at the craft store if you're going to make a silk flower arrangement or something like that. And some of these came with a whole bunch of berries on little branches, and I just cut them off and bent the little wires into hooks, and I have them hanging all over the tree. So there's little red ones and some sparkly gold ones. I've got these little clear ball ones that hang from a wire. It's just a lot. It's a lot. I've got also the lights. I have 9 strands of lights, and I don't remember how many are on a strand. I was a kind of an early adopter of LED lights. I waited 1 year for the after Christmas sales, because LED lights, when they first came out, were rather expensive. And during the after Christmas sales, this one particular store was selling everything they had 50% off. And I bought what they had left, which was 9 boxes of these LED lights. And that's what's on my tree. Since I like a lot of lights, LED lights make sense. They use less electricity. They generate, they're not hot. They don't generate heat like incandescents do, which is better for you when you have a real tree. Unfortunately, because I bought them early, they're an early generation of LED lights, which have a, even though they're technically white, they have a bluish cast to them. And that wouldn't be so bad, except that my tree topper, which is a great big ball encrusted with white incandescent lights, so it has a yellowish cast. So my tree topper and my tree lights don't quite go together. One of these days I'll replace my LEDs with current generation LED lights that are more true white light instead of that bluish cast. It's hard to justify spending the money when you got perfectly good lights that work. So anyway, when I take the camera out there and shoot a little bit of the tree, you'll see the difference in the lights, and I apologize. So that's the story behind my tree. That is why it took me a week to decorate it. And come the first of the year, when I take her down and pack away all the ornaments, I will count how many come off that tree and let you know just how many. You can make guesses if you'd like. You post your comments below if you want to take a guess as to how many ornaments are on my tree. I'm afraid it's going to be a really big number. So anyway, let's go check it out. Okay, so here is this year's Christmas tree. As you can see, the topper and the lights don't quite match. Oh well. Let me come in a little bit closer. You can get a feel for just how many ornaments are on this tree. Yeah, there's a few. Yeah, believe it or not, there actually is a tree underneath of all that. This bird here, that's one of the newest pieces I just got. Reminded me of an ornament that I made my mom when I was a little kid. And, whoops, let's go this way. There's my polar bear that I like so much. And there's that great big crystal snowflake. That's like the one I got my Aunt Thelma. And there's my flag ornament that I got after 9/11. And let's see. The angel, the paper angel that my daughter made when she was very, very young. So you can get a feel. There's a few ornaments on my tree. You know, just a few. You can see some of the seashell ornaments. There's another one over there. Got lots of those. They tend to be all clustered around the top of the tree because they're rather small. And you see all the various little plastic icicles and the various sundry other dangly things that I have on my tree. So, and all the way down at the bottom, the safe ornaments, the felt ones and things like that. So, all right, now you've seen the massive tree filled with ornaments. Not enough, don't you agree? That's all for this week. Come back and see me.
See ya.